Wow, this goat meat from Merchant Ali is so good. My mother once told me she wanted to try it. But Merchant Ali is in Empire of Malacca. Meanwhile, I am in Perlis. It will take me 7 days to arrive there, and by the time I'm back here, the goat meat will be spoiled. How can I get this for my mother?
Something. Can I know what year is it?
It's the 1900s.
Why did you ask?
Oh, I'm from the future, 2023.
Can I ask, why are you looking at me such a sad face?
I saw this advertisement and want to buy it. But the merchant is so far away, and the goat meat will be spoiled by the time I arrive back here.
In 2023, to settle this problem, we have a digital commerce.
Digital commerce, what is that?
Digital commerce is an electronic buying and selling of goods. We don't even have to meet the merchant to buy our items. We have so many platforms now to buy and sell our items. There are Shopee, Lazada, Amazon, Shein, Sephora, Zalora, and the list goes on.
If you don't meet the merchant, how do you give your money? And how do you get your items? Does it come out of these quittings of yours?
Totally no. There are a few steps in buying and selling goods in digital commerce. First, the seller will upload their products on their websites and platforms. There will be pictures and descriptions to guide buyers. Second, buyer will pay using online payment, which means our money is in digital form. It is all number with real money values. Third, sellers will use courier to deliver their products to customers. Fourth, customers will receive their items safely in the comfort of their own home. And that's it.
Wow, that's so easy. But doesn't all this easiness come with issues?
Well, yeah, of course, there are some problems and issues, but here, let me show you.
Oh, hello. Assalamualaikum. Who is there?
Hello, is this Madam Munira?
Yes, I am. Who am I talking to?
I'm Miss Lisa. I'm calling from MC Bank. It seems that you have a total amount of RM2,700 debt with our bank that's yet to be settled.
2,700 ringgit debt? How come I have this debt?
That is totally common among our customers. You might have debt years ago that you didn't realize. It started with small amount, then when years gone and the debt is settled, the interest start to pile up and sum up to a huge amount.
Oh no! Oh, this must be the debt from my dead husband. Oh, I don't realize this. What do I do now, Miss Lisa?
Oh, I totally want to help you, and actually, because you are a loyal customer of ABC Bank, I will give you a discount of RM200, so you only have to pay RM2500 if you pay now. Do you want to proceed?
Oh, of course! I want to step in it lump sum. I have KWSP money. What do I do?
Okay, give me your IC number, bank card number, and the expiry date of your bank card.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. Mai! Bring me my purse!
Why, Ma? What do you need it for?
I want to pay the ABC Bank debt. I think it's your late father's debt. We have a total debt of RM2,700. So I want to give this banker that is calling me my card number, my expiry date of the card, my bank card number, because she said if I pay right now, I can reduce the debt to RM2,500. So I want to pay right now, so your father can rest in peace.
Wait, don't do it, Mom. That is a scam.
What?
Hey, rotten human, you then scam old folk out of their money. Stop scamming people.
Bombastic side eye.
How do you know that it's a scammer? How if it was a legit banker? We have debts to settle.
It was shared on social media about the modus operandi that this can be used. The tactic are saying just like happened to you. A victim actually lost around 100k.
Well then, how do I know the truth and the scammer one?
If you ever receive that type of phone call again, just hang up and walk to the nearest branch of bank to clarify the matters. Usually, legit bank will not send information through SMS or phone call, but they will send official letter to us.
Oh, I see. Fortunately, you stopped me, or we could have lost so much money. Thank you, my daughter, Mai.
Hello, girls. Today, I would like to review the product that totally changed my life. Here, the virus serum. You can see how this serum gives me a bright complexion and no acne. So, buy it now.
Whoa! Her skin looks so good and flawless. The XX serum must have worked so good. I want skin like hers. I'm buying it right now.
Super toner I'm holding right now. This is one of the best toner I have ever used. It totally cleaned my face and now I have no skin problem. So check out now because there is RM20 discount.
Whoa, look at this influencer's skin. Her skin is so flawless and smooth. No acne. I want skin like her. If I use this product, I will get skin like her too. I will be pretty and popular. I'm buying it right now.
Several days later.
Oh no! Why is my skin becoming horrible? Acne is popping up everywhere. It's itchy. It hurts and it burns when I go out in the sun. What did I do wrong? I only use products that were recommended by the influencer. They got pretty skin when they used the product, but why did my skin become horrible? I'm so scared to go to sleep right now because the acne might pop and it hurts so bad. What did I do wrong? Oh, what? What is this?
Well, guys, do you know the influencer that is selling XX product skincare? Apparently, the product that she been selling got banned because the product has such an harmful ingredient such as mercury.
Nani?
Many users has reported getting bad reaction from the product and asked the influencer to give a statement. But the influencer just kept selling the products and ignored the comment. So be safe out there. Don't buy any product or skincare before doing some research.
Oh, why was I so blinded by her promotions? Now, all my money was spent on the products and my skin has become worse. I shouldn't have been tempted to do impulse buying and should have do my research before buying things online. I'm super regretful right now.
Oh no, that's too bad. That's all of this issue are happening.
Yes, it is. But we should focus more on the bright side. Digital commerce totally help us much better rather than be a burden.
Oh really? Like why?
Well, because the commerce can be done anytime, anywhere, using any devices. We don't even need to get out of our houses. We just order it and the item will be delivered by courier services.
What about the price? Is it more pricey?
Surprisingly, buying on digital commerce platform costs lower because they are online shopping platforms that help customers to compare price. So, smart buyer will choose the most affordable ones, and also customer can use discount when shopping. And even free delivery fees were offered. So, buying from digital commerce totally helped us cut costs.
Wow, I'm so jealous of your era. Hopefully, your people will utilize it and not take it for granted, especially our responsible individuals that will rely for money.
Yes, digital commerce is great and cannot be used for wrong purposes. Oh no, my time is up. I might get stuck here if I don't leave now. Thank you, lady, for chatting with me. Goodbye.
Thank you too for sharing with me. Goodbye.
You want to see it?
Okay.
You want to see it? Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Here is her picture. She's so pretty, right? I really like how she looks so the Malay type. She seems like she's from there.
Three, two, one, action.
Of course. I have KWW.